come, Creator Spirit, and move over this chaotic world. Come, Creator Spirit, and bring life to this world. Come, Creator Spirit, and move over the chaos of our lives. Come, Creator Spirit, and bring us new life. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Ari rapile. Mo dimo ya matla ohle, yo dipelo tsohle di buletseng, ditakatso tsohle di tsejwa, yo seletho le patilweng ho wena, hlwekisa megopolo ya dipelo tsa rona, ka pudulelo ya moya wa hao o halalelang, hore re tle re rate ka lerato le phethileng, re hodise lebitso la hao le halalelang, ka Kreste Morena wa rona. Morena re gagoele, Morena, Morena re gagoele, Morena re gagoele, o Kreste re gagoele, Kreste re gagoele, o Kreste, Kreste re gagoele, Kreste re gagoele, Morena re gagoele, Morena re gagoele, Morena mo Rena re gagoele, mo Rena re gagoele. Let us confess our sins. Lord Jesus, you ask that we do not grieve your Holy Spirit. Yet, by our actions in this world, we risk just that day after day. We see life all around us and consider it disposable. We extinguish the lives of animals as if their lives did not matter in your sight. We toss away species of plants and animals as if their existence were happenstance and not the result of your creative activity. Lord Jesus, give us reverence for life and help us to see your Spirit at work in this world. We ask and pray all this through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy on you. Pardon your sins and set you free from them. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness and keep you in eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. To you, God, Jesus prayed that we might be one. Help us to transcend our differences and find our unity in Jesus Christ our Lord. Lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Numere Khalo ya leshome le motsumo re bale go tloga ka temana ya mashome a mabedi ya metsumine. Ebe lentswe la Modimo le sa foseng le re, yaba Moshe o a tswa a phethela setšhaba mantswe a Jehova, a kgetha bagolo ba setšhaba, banna ba mashome a supileng, mme a ba emisa a ba etela tenteng gare. Jehova a theoha leru a bua le yena a nka moyeng o le mong hodima moshe a o beha hodima baholo ba mashume a supileng itse gobane moya o dule hodima bona ham ba hla ba profeta empa ba seke ba hlola ba phetha ho ne ho setse banna ba babedi di ahelo lebitso la emong e le eldade la emong e le medade me moya wa dula hodima bona le ha e ne e le ba kgethilweng ba ne ba sa ka ba ya tenteng me ba profeta di ahelo ya ba mohlanka e mong wa titima a bolella moshe a re bo eldade le bo medade ba profeta di ahelo mo Joshua moganune e ne e le mohlanka wa moshe ha e sale botjheng ba hae a bua a re marenaka moshe ba thibele moshe a re na wa mpoulela na o hoja setšhaba kaofela sa Jehova se ka fela sa profeta me Jehova a beya moya wa hae hodima bona me moshe a tloha a ya diahelong yena le baholo ba Iseraele utlwang lentswe la Morena.
Today's scripture reading will be taken from Psalm 104, verse 24 to verse 34. Lord, you have made so many things. How wise you are. Where, when you made all these things? The earth is full of your creations. Look at the ocean, so big and wide. It is filled with more creatures than people can count. It is filled with living things from the largest to the smallest. Ship sails back and forth on it. Leviathan, the sea monster, you made it, plays in it. You created all creations depend on you to give them food when they need it. When you give it to them, they eat it. When you open your hand, they are satisfied with good things. When you turn your face away from them, they are terrified. When you take away their breath, they turn back into dust. When you send your spirit to create them, you give new life to the ground. May the Lord, the glory of the Lord continue forever. May the Lord be happy with what he has made. When he looks at the earth, it trembles. When he touches the mountain, they pour out smoke. I will sing to the Lord all my life. I will sing praise my God as long as I live. May these thoughts of mine please him. Amen.
Spirit of the Lord. Omwa nakare nane. Evangeli pa Yohane somi apuki onoporo ni heali. Tatu reshe verise yomirongo ndatu na ndatu. Sigo verise yomirongo ndatu na mugoi. Yesus okuyaro mbwele. Ngame undripune okathimbo okafupi na tango. Opoihe otandi kungoka atomunje. Nena otamuka kara no kukonga nge. Ihe itamuka mona nge. Oshoka hoka tandika kara. Kamuvuru okuyako. Ayuda oyapurathana yati. Omnume nunguka otaipeni ando moka itatu monoe. Otaikira ndo yagereka. Hoka kwa kara ayuda akaronge angereka. Oye okwahara okutya ngi nisho tati. Ne otamukara no kukonga nge. Ne itamuka mona nje. Naho katandi itamuvuru okuyako. Esikuja huguni na liyeshituthi olyathiki. Liyasima na unene. Esikujo olyo tunjo ka Yesus okwathikama no kuigitha ati. Kehengo ka asa enota ne kungame amwe. Ngashi kwanyorwa takuti.
Good morning, dear Anglicans. My name is Natalie Simons-Arendse and I'm from St. Philip's Church in Kenwyn in the Diocese of Cape Town. Today is Pentecost, a great celebration in the church calendar and significantly the day in which the President calls for us to have a national day of prayer. Today we celebrate Pentecost as the birthday of the church. And on this day, we celebrate how believers in Jesus Christ formed a family of faith with a divine purpose. In fact, it was already an important day for the Jewish believers, and it gained new meaning for Christians after Easter. The early church was born on this day, and it fueled in them to go out and conquer the world. It energized the lives of Christians and many others, and it was a day that brought about great change. So let us look at Pentecost in the past, Pentecost at the present, and Pentecost in the future. If we look in the past, before this day in Acts chapter 2, we will find a different sort of Pentecost celebration. If you were to walk up to any person in that particular day and ask them what Pentecost meant, they would tell you that it was a great feast held in Jerusalem every year, and it was called the Feast of Weeks or Shavuot. It had a double significance, and it marked the important wheat festival in the land of Israel, and it also commemorated the anniversary of the day that God gave the Torah to the entire nation of Israel as they assembled at Mount Sinai. So everyone would make the journey to Jerusalem for this feast, and they were celebrating a year of hard work in the fields and harvesting, and it was a celebration to give thanks to God for God's provision. So at the moment there's a Jewish feast going on, and they find that together everyone is celebrating. They're having a good time and they are giving thanks for the year. And they are following a tradition that they had grown up with. So Pentecost is a time of celebration where people would feast and be thankful for God's provision. Pentecost at present, we know who we are and we know who was there. In Acts chapter 1, we hear that the believers in Jesus Christ were gathered as they normally were, and they were waiting on Christ as they had been instructed to do. And so it would seem that for these Christians who were celebrating Pentecost together, it was going to take on a whole new meaning, because now there would be witnesses and participants at the birth of the church. The main difference of this day of Pentecost and the day of Pentecost before was that the Holy Spirit was going to come in a mighty way and in a new way. And the Spirit, like the wind, is a powerful force. Just ask anyone who's ever had their home's roof blown off or have a tree uprooted in their backyard. The wind is powerful, and so is the Spirit of God. And the Spirit came in a very powerful day on the day of Pentecost. We also find that the Holy Spirit came in fire. Not only did they hear the Spirit come, but they saw it as well. They saw fire appear, and a little flame came to each of them and rested on them. The fire meant something very important. We find in Exodus chapter 3, when God appeared to Moses in the burning bush, it meant that Moses was in the presence of God. And in Exodus 13, when God led the people of Israel out of Egypt, he did so with a pillar of fire, meaning that the people of God were being led by the presence of God. And in Exodus 19 and 24, that was when God was present on Mount Sinai at the top of the mountain, and there was fire and it was blazing. And so again, the presence of God was with them. And in this passage in Acts, we find the meaning to be the same. The very Spirit of God was amongst them and was able to take up residence in their hearts. They actually saw the fire come to each one of them, and they saw that God was there and was about to anoint them to do the work of the church. And the Spirit came in power on the day of Pentecost. We find that the Spirit came and allowed those who were there to speak in tongues. What an amazing miracle for the beginning of the church. And really, if you think about it, the Holy Spirit was providing exactly what the apostles and the others needed to proclaim the gospel. The rest of the passage tells us that there were Jews from 14 different nations around the world, 14 different languages that had to be learned so that the gospel could be preached. Through the power of God, these apostles were given the gift to speak and to be heard by everyone in their native language. Thousands and thousands of Jews were there in Jerusalem and were able to hear their own language being spread from the gospel. Amazing and wonderful. And the Holy Spirit came in power in this day of Pentecost, and everyone saw it demonstrated. And so the church is born. The Holy Spirit now came to rest on the followers of Jesus, and they could go out and do as he had asked them to do, to spread the gospel. The church had been started, and they were about to go out to do the Father's work. Pentecost in the future. This day of Pentecost was really just the beginning for the church, and there was so much more to look forward to. The most important aspect of this day was that the Holy Spirit came down for the believers in a new way. Jesus asked them to wait, and they waited patiently. They needed to wait before the Holy Spirit could come. Before, in the Old Testament times, the Spirit of God was with God's people, but not on a permanent basis. And we don't really understand that, because post-Pentecost, we know that the Spirit is with us all the time. And so, to be honest, the people in the Old Testament would really marvel at how God would work constantly among God's people. Human beings have always been obsessed with the future. Nations are so set on being world leaders that we've destroyed so much of what has freely been given to us. Our water levels are decreasing. Our snow caps are melting. Food security is at risk. The rivers are polluted. Our marine life is suffering. while we wait for the new iPhone to come onto the market. The time of isolation and lockdown has helped us to almost reboot, to see through the smog and the pollution that we have created. It's no coincidence that we are called to have a National Day of Prayer on the day of Pentecost. We as a church, we as God's people, we as the ones to whom the Holy Spirit has been given, have a chance now to look to a new Pentecost, to receive the Holy Spirit, and to be equipped to be the church in new ways to God's people. And so as we come together in our various places and spaces this Sunday, and as we pray earnestly for the gift of the Holy Spirit to come with fire and to come and make our church and us a new people, we pray that we will not have Pentecost only once a year, but that we have Pentecost every day, and we receive the gift of the Holy Spirit as we receive the gift of God's earth. Amen.
Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful people and kindle with them the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit, and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. Renew the face of our earth, loving Creator, as you can only do through us. Help us realize our part in earth's sufferings and our call to act on behalf of our brothers and sisters and the global systems that sustain all life. Let us be grateful for the wonders of creation, for the gifts of the Spirit in all creation, for fresh, clear air. We are grateful. For rich, healthful soil, we are grateful. For pure, cool water, we are grateful. For healthful crops, we are grateful. For the thousands of species that grace our earth, we are grateful. For the interdependence that each of the above has with us and with one another, we are grateful. For all those who are working to help renew our earth, we are grateful. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful people and kindle with them the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit, and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth.
First day. she is the Spirit, one with God in essence, gifted by the Savior in eternal love. She is the King, opening the Scriptures, enemy of apathy and heavenly
The risen Christ came and stood among his disciples and said, "Peace be with you." Then they were glad when they saw the Lord. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Peace be with you.
Come, Holy Spirit, move among us. Come,
be with you, and also with you. Lift up your hearts, we lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give him thanks and praise. Blessed are you, strong and faithful God. All your works, the height and the depth, echo the silent music of your praise. In the beginning, your word summoned light. Night withdrew and creation dawned. As ages passed unseen, waters gathered on the face of the earth and life appeared. When time had at last grown full and the earth had ripened into abundance, you created in your own image humankind. You gave us breath and speech that the whole creation might find a voice to sing your praise. Therefore, with all the powers of heaven and earth, we chant the ageless hymn of your glory. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. How wonderful are the works of your hands, O Lord. As a mother hen tenderly gathers her chicks, so you embraced a people as your own and filled them with longing for a peace that would last and a justice that would never fail. Through countless generations, your people hungered for the bread of freedom. From them you raised up Jesus, the living bread, in whom the ancient hungers were satisfied. He healed the sick, though he himself would suffer. He offered life to sinners through death. He offered life to sinners, though death would hunt him down. With love stronger than death, he opened wide his arms on the cross and surrendered his spirit to you, Father. Father, let your Holy Spirit move in power over us and over our earthly gifts of bread and wine, that they may become to us the body and blood of Christ. On the night before he met with death, Jesus came to a table with those he loved. He took the loaf and praised you. God of all creation. He broke it among his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given for you." When supper was ended, he poured a final cup and blessed you, God of all creation. He passed the cup among his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in remembrance of me." Father, we commemorate Jesus, your Son, as we present before you his sacrifice. Death could not bind him, for you raised him up in the spirit of holiness and exalted him as Lord of creation. May his coming in glory find us ever watchful in prayer, strong in love, and faithful to the breaking of the bread. Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Dying, you destroyed our death. Rising, you restored our life. Lord Jesus, in glory. Rejoicing in the Holy Spirit, your whole church offers you thanks and praise. In oneness with all creation, we sing your praise through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, with him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. We say the environmental Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, you are also at home in the air, soil, forests, and oceans. Hallowed be your name by the care we take of your creation. Your kingdom come. All that you see is good. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Your will to till and care. Give us this day our daily bread, that all may have sufficient to live in life in fullness. Forgive us our sins, our greed, our exploitation, our lack of concern for other species and for future generations. As we forgive those who sin against us, by reconciliation with justice, save us from the time of trial, the temptation to equate dominion with exploitation, and deliver us from evil, the evil of destroying your gift of creation, for the kingdom, yours, Lord, not ours, the power and the glory in the cross and the resurrection are yours now and forever. You were the beginning, and you are the end. Amen. The bread which we break, is it not a sharing of the body of Christ? We, who are many, are one body, for we all partake of the one bread. We do not presume to come to this your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under your table, but you are the same Lord, whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood which he shed for you. Feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving.
Jesus' name so serene, Emmanuel name so serene.